Hello friends, welcome back. My name is PK. In this video, you will learn how to create a dynamic comparison in butterfly chart. So as you are seeing my screen, I have created this dynamic butterfly chart wherein you can compare two employees sale together for multiple dates. Let me show you the data first. We have this data wherein we have multiple dates in column A. Then we have employee's name in multiple columns, and this is the sales for employees in a particular date. Now here we want to compare two employees sale dynamically for rolling 7 days. Here you can see we have selected these two employees in the combo box, and this is showing the 1st gen to 7th gen sale for these two employees. You can change the employee name from the drop down. So let's say I want to compare this employee with this first employee. So automatically it has changed the chart and the numbers of the employees. You can change the dates also using this scroll bar. So let's say this is 1st to 7th. I want to see 2nd to 8th, and you can just see the rolling 7 day date. You can change the employee from here. So this is totally dynamic chart, and friends, I will explain you how can you create this in Microsoft Excel. So please watch this video till the end. Let's start without delay. I'm going to copy this data. Press Ctrl N to add a new workbook and just paste this data here. Alright, so this is our data sheet. Now let me add a support sheet here. And now let me add a chart sheet here. Here we will create our chart and we will take the support here. So let me copy all the employees from here first. Just copy these employees and just paste somewhere here in the column as value and transpose data. Click on OK. So it is in one column now. Alright. Here we will take our scroll bar value. Then here we will take employee 1 value. In the next column, we will take employee 2 value. Alright, so I will explain you the employee 1 value and the employee 2 value and the scroll bar value. So let me go to the chart, and here first go to the view and uncheck the grid lines. Then I will go to the developer tab and I will insert from the form control this combo box. Just drag the combo box here. Right click, go to the format control and go to the input range. Now in the input range, we will provide the range of employee from support sheet, this range. And cell link we will provide on support sheet. So this will be the employee 1 value. And drop down value you can change to maximum. Let's say we have 10 employees, so let's put here 20 or 10. 15, it will show all employee in one view. Click on OK. Now you can see we have all 10 employee here. If I will select the first employee, then go to the support sheet. The value of employee 1 is 1. If I will select the second employee, then it is showing. So I have selected third employee, so it is showing 3. If I will select second employee, it will show 2. Alright, now I'll make a copy of this. Just copy and paste. This is my second employee value. So just right click, go to the format control, and we will change only cell link. In place of K2, we will take L2. Just click here. Alright, so you can select any name from here. Now on the support sheet, we have the value of combo box. It is the 1st, 2nd, 3rd or 5th. So you can see here. Alright, now I'll create a scroll bar. So go to the chart worksheet, and here we will go to the developer tab, insert, form controls, and we will insert a scroll bar. And we will drag it vertically like this. Let's keep this here. Right click, go to the format control. And now here we will provide the minimum value and maximum value, incremental one and the cell link. So let's see how we will provide the minimum and maximum value first. So let me go to the data sheet. Now in the data, our actual date is starting from row number 2. So minimum value we will take row number 2. Now let's take how many count is there of the dates. So we have 49 counts. Now from the 49 we will minus 7. That will be 42. But our first row is header. We will add 1. That will be 43. So maximum we will take 43 and minimum we will take 2. So come to the chart, right click on the scroll bar, format, control, and here minimum we will take 2, maximum we will take 43, and you can change this maximum value as your date is increasing in your data sheet. Incremental we will take 1, then cell length. In the cell length, just select here, go to the support sheet, and we will select the scroll bar value on J2. Click on OK. Now, just check, change the value. Come to the support sheet, you can see scroll bar value is getting changed now. Alright. Okay, now here we will put date. Then, in the date, we will use index formula. Index, and come to the data sheet. I will select the first column here, comma, and in the row, I will take the scroll bar value, this one, and just hit the enter. Change the format as date, press shift control 3. So it is showing HN. And if I will take minimum value, just move to the right or top side, then it will show first gen. And here I can use plus 1. So we are showing these 7 days on the chart. You can take more days if you want to take more days. Now here we will take the name of the first employee and name of the second employee. Means whatever you have selected on the first combo box and second combo box. So what we can do here, we will use index and let's take this range, comma. First take the employee 1 value, press enter. So it is showing whatever you have selected in first combo box. Same formula we will use here, index, this range, comma, row number we will take employee 2 value, this one. So here it is showing whatever you have selected on second combo box. Alright, now we want to get the actual sale value for these employees. So here you can use index function with match, or you can use the VLOOKUP function also with match. So whatever you want to use, because our data in this manner, so we can use the VLOOKUP also. Alright, so let's use the VLOOKUP here. So what we will do, use VLOOKUP and let's take the lookup value, this one, comma, go to the data, and from date you can take till the end. So I'm taking here till 11, comma. For now, I'm putting here 2, 0 and just close. Press enter. Now, because I have put here 2, so it is returning the sale for this employee. Now, in place of 2, you can use the dynamic value. If I will select any other name here, then you can see this value is not getting changed because we have made 2 hard code here. So what we will do, we will make dynamic to this 2. So how we can make it? We will use match function. Let me show you. We can use match, and in the match lookup value, we will take this cell, freeze this row. So put the dollar sign here, comma. Come to the data sheet and let's select this entire row and just press F4 to freeze this, comma, 0, and just close the bracket. So you can see it is returning 6. But if I will select here first employee, then it will return 2. So that means it is returning dynamic column number. So just select this formula, copy this formula, come to your VLOOKUP formula, in place of 2, just paste this formula and just hit the enter. So here you can see it is returning 30, but if I will change the value of this combo box, then it will return the sale accordingly. Alright, now let me delete this, and we will use the same formula for the second employee also. So just copy the formula and paste here. The only thing, in place of this reference, we will use this one and just hit the enter. Just fill this formula down. Now we are getting the dynamic values here. Now we will take two more support column here. The first column we will take the padding for the left hand side. So I'll use your left padding. And the left padding we will take dynamically. First let's take the max value from here, the maximum value. And just freeze this because it will be fixed for this range. And from the maximum value we will minus this value. And just hit the enter. And just fill this formula down. Okay, so this is the maximum value. And for rest it is taking the padding. Now here we will use the space for the middle space basically of the chart. So we can use some average. Let's take the average value. Either you can take the average of this one or let's take the average for entire data. You can select entire range from here. Just hit the enter. Let's freeze this. Press F4. Now fill this formula down. Alright, so we have completed our working. Now we will select this range and then we will go to the insert and then we will go to the charts and we will take 3D stack bar chart. Just click here. Now we have this chart ready. Now we will do some formatting here. First remove the grid lines from here and right click, go to the select data. In this select data, left padding we will put on the top, so it will come on the first. Then the first employee, so first employee name is this one. Then we will put the space, then the second employee. Just click on OK. Right click, go to the 3D rotation and the Y rotation we will take 0. X rotation also we will take 0. Just close this. Now again right click, go to the format data series. And here we will take cylinder and the gap width we will take around 5 or 10%, or let's keep 15%. Alright. Now for this left padding we will fill no color, so just take the no fill. And for this middle section we will take white color, so fill here white. And for these two you can keep the color as per your requirement. I have kept here this blue color and this one golden accent for this. Alright. Now here you can see the date is not in proper order. The 7 Jan is coming on top and first at bottom. So what you can do, right click, go to the format axis and then just scroll it down. Here you can see option is available, dates in reverse order. Just select this and just close. Now you can see date is in proper order. Now just select the chart and go to this plus button and from here just uncheck the axis and the title of the axis also and the legends also. Now go to this plus button again and go to the data labels. So data labels are enabled now. Now for the left padding just select this data label and press delete. Select the middle data label, right click, go to the format data labels. And here you can select value from cells and we will take this date range here. Just click on OK and uncheck the value and solar lines. Just close this. Now format the data label, let's take the black color and make it bold. Similarly here, black color and bold, black color and bold. Alright, so our chart is ready. Now select the plot area. Just select the chart, go to the format. In the current selection, you can select the plot area, this one. Move to the right hand side slightly. Now select the chart, press Ctrl X, cut this. Come to the chart and just paste this chart here. Just put it here, right click and send it to back. Alright, so we have the employee name here. Keep the scroll bar here. If I will select any other employee, then you can see it is changing the values and you can change the dates also. If I will use this scroll bar, it is changing the date also. Okay, so you can put a text box here or word art here. You can select all elements together, right click and make this group. Alright, if I will select any other employee, then you can see it is getting changed. If I will use this scroll bar, then dates are getting changed. Alright friends, so friends, that is how you can create this dynamic butterfly chart in Microsoft Excel. You can use it in your Excel dashboard to compare two employees together. I hope you have enjoyed this video. Friends, if you like this video, please hit the like button and please subscribe my channel to get the regular update of my videos. Thank you so much for watching.